Scene 5, Capulet's Orchard. Enter Romeo and Juliet aloft.
Wilt thou be gone? It is not yet near day. It was the nightingale and not the lark that pierced the fearful hollow of thine ear. Nightly she sings on yon pomegranate tree. Believe me, love, it was the nightingale.
It was the lark, the herald of the morn, no nightingale. Look, love, what envious streaks do lace the severing clouds in yonder east. Night's candles are burnt out, and jocund day stands tiptoe on the misty mountain tops. I must be gone and live, or stay and die.
Yond light is not daylight, I know it, I. It is some meteor that the sun exhales, to be to thee this night a torch-bearer, and light thee on thy way to Mantua. Therefore stay yet, thou needest not to be gone.
Let me be ta'en, let me be put to death. I am content, so thou wilt have it so. I'll say yon gray is not the morning's eye, 'tis but the pale reflex of Cynthia's brow. Nor that is not the lark whose notes do beat the vaulty heaven so high above our heads. I have more care to stay than will to go. Come, death, and welcome. Juliet wills it so. How is it, my soul? Let's talk. It is not day.
It is, it is. Hie hence, begone, away. It is the lark that sings so out of tune, straining harsh discords and unpleasing sharps. Some say the lark makes sweet division. This doth not so, for she divideth us. Some say the lark and loathed toad change eyes. Oh, now I would they had changed voices too, since arm from arm that voice doth us affray, hunting thee hence with hunts up to the day. Oh, now be gone, more light and light it grows.
More light and light, more dark and dark our woes.
Enter nurse.
Madam.
Nurse.
Your lady mother is coming to your chamber. The day is broke. Be wary. Look about.
Exit.
Then window let day in and let life out.
Farewell, my love. One more kiss and I'll descend.
Art thou gone so, love lord, a husband friend? I must hear from thee every day in the hour, for in a minute there are many days. Oh, by this count I shall be much in years, ere I again behold my Romeo.
Farewell. I will omit no opportunity that may convey my greetings, love, to thee.
Oh, thinkest thou we shall ever meet again?
I doubt it not. And all these woes shall serve for sweet discourses in our times to come.
O God, I have an ill-divining soul. Methinks I see thee, now thou art so low, as one dead in the bottom of a tomb. Either my eyesight fails, or thou lookest pale.
And trust me, love, in my eyes so do you. Dry sorrows drinks our blood. Adieu. Adieu.
Fortune. All men call you fickle because no fortune ever constant be. If that is so, then change again, O fortune. Be fickle now and send him back to me.
Enter mother.
Ho, daughter, are you up?
Who is that calls? It is my lady mother. Is she not down so late or up so early? What unaccustomed cause procures her hither?
Why, how now, Juliet?
Madam, I am not well.
Evermore weeping for your cousin's death? What, wilt thou wash him from his grave with tears? And if thou couldst, thou couldst not make him live. Therefore have done. Some grief shows much of love, but much of grief shows still some want of wit.
Yet let me weep for such a feeling loss.
So shall you feel the loss, but not the friend which you weep for.
Feeling so the loss, I cannot choose but ever weep the friend.
Well, girl, thou weep'st not so much for his death as that the villain lives which slaughtered him.
What villain, madam?
That same villain, Romeo.
Juliet aside.
Villain and he be many miles asunder. God pardon him. I do, with all my heart. And yet no man like he doth grieve my heart.
That is because the traitor murderer lives.
Aye, madam, from the reach of these my hands. Would none but I might venge my cousin's death.
We will have vengeance for it, fear thou not. Then weep no more. I'll send to one in Mantua, where that same banished runagate doth live, shall give him such an unaccustomed dram that he shall soon keep Tybalt company, and then I hope thou wilt be satisfied.
Indeed, I never shall be satisfied with Romeo till I behold him, dead. Is my poor heart so for a kinsman vexed? Madam, if you could find out but a man to bear a poison, I would temper it, that Romeo should, upon receipt thereof, soon sleep in quiet. Oh, how my heart abhors to hear him named and cannot come to him, to wreak the love I bore my cousin upon his body that hath slaughtered him.
Find thou the means, and I'll find such a man, but now I'll tell thee joyful tidings, girl.
And joy comes well in such a needy time. What are they, beseech your ladyship?
Well, well, thou hast a careful father, child, one who, to put thee from thy heaviness, hath sorted out a sudden day of joy that thou expects not, nor I look not for.
Madam, in happy time, what day is that?
Marry, my child, early next Thursday morn, the gallant young and noble gentleman, the county Paris at St. Peter's Church, shall happily make thee there a joyful bride.
Now by St. Peter's Church, and Peter too. He shall not make me there a joyful bride. I wonder at this haste, that I must wed, ere he that should be husband comes to woo. I pray you tell my lord and father, madam, I will not marry yet, and when I do, I swear it shall be Romeo, whom you know I hate, rather than Paris. These are news indeed.
Here comes your father. Tell him so yourself, and see how he will take it at your hands.
Enter Capulet and Nurse.
When the sun sets, the earth doth drizzle dew. But for the sunset of my brother's son, it rains downright.
My girl is like a channel. What more tears? The level of the sea will start to lift if much more water flows from your sweet eyes.
Wife, have you told her of her marriage plans?
I have. And she will have none of it, I swear.
Soft.
Soft. Take me with you, wife. How? Will she none? Does she not give us thanks? Is she not proud? Does she not think her blessed, unworthy as she is, that we have brought so worthy a gentleman to be her groom?
Thankful I am and grateful for your love, but proud I cannot be of what I hate.
How? Chopped logic. What is this? Proud, and I thank you, but I thank you not. Thank me no thankings, nor proud me no prouds. Be ready, lady, Thursday morning next, to go with Paris to St. Peter's Church, or I will drag thee thither on a rail!
Out, you green sickness carrion, out, you baggage, you tallow face!
Fie, fie! What, are you mad?
Good father, I beseech you on my knees. Hear me with patience, but to speak a word.
Hang thee, young baggage, disobedient wretch. I tell thee what, get thee to church a Thursday, or never after look me in the face. Speak not, reply not, do not answer me. My fingers itch. Wife, we scarce thought us blessed that God had lent us but this only child. But now I see this one is one too much, and that we have a curse in having her. Out on her, Hilding!
God in heaven bless her. You are to blame, my lord, to rate her so.
And why, my lady wisdom, hold your tongue? Good prudence! Smatter with your gossips. Go!
I speak no treason.
O God in Gordon!
May not one speak.
Peace, you mumbling fool. Utter your gravity or a gossip's bowl, for here we need it not.
You are too hot.
God's blood, you just make me mad! Day, night, month, year! My constant care has been to have my only child worthily matched. And here I find an educated man of equal birth, with honorable parts, with fine estates, and handsome to behold. And what is my reward? A puking fool who answers, "I'll not wed, I cannot love. I am too young, I pray you pardon me." Now think on this. Thursday is near. If you will play the bride, then are you my daughter and all is forgot. If you will not, then you are mine no more. Graze where you will, you shall not house with me. Beg, starve, or hang, I'll ne'er acknowledge thee, nor pass to you the slightest thing that's mine. I swear to this, my word, so help me God.
Exit.
Is there no pity sitting in the clouds that sees into the bottom of my grief? Oh, sweet my mother, cast me not away. Delay this marriage for a month, a week, or if you do not, make the bridal bed in that dim monument where Tybalt lies.
Talk not to me, for I'll not speak a word. Do as thou wilt, for I have done with thee.
Exit.
Oh, nurse! How shall this be prevented? I have a living husband here on earth. What, should I take a second in a lie and cast myself forever into hell?
Well, here it is. Romeo is gone and cannot come back except in stealth at risk to life and limb. Given that case which will not alter soon, I think it best you marry with the Count.
Speakest thou from thy heart?
And from my soul. Or the devil take us all.
What?
Well, thou hast comforted me marvelous much. Go in and tell my lady I am gone, having displeased my father to Lawrence's cell, to make confession and to be absolved.
Marry, I will, and this is wisely done.
Exit.
Ancient damnation! O most wicked fiend! Is it more sin to wish me thus forsworn, or to dispraise my lord with that same tongue which she hath praised him with above compare so many thousand times? Go, counselor, thou and my bosom henceforth shall be twain. I'll to the friar to know his remedy. If all else fail, myself have power to die.
Exit.